السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا
يا ربي لك الحمد. لك الحمد يا ربي كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك ولعظيم سلطانك. نحمدك اللهم على كل نعمة أنعمتها علينا، ونخص بذكر منها هديك إيانا إلى الصراط المستقيم. ونسألك اللهم أن تزيدنا إيمانا وتسليما وهدى وتقوى، وأن تجعلنا من عبادك المتقين الذين يعبدونك وحدك لا يشركون بك شيئا. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له في ربوبيته وألوهيته وكمال أسمائه وصفاته. ونشهد بعد ذلك أن محمداً صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله عبد الله ورسوله، وأن الله تعالى قد أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله. ونشهد أن رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة، فندعو الله تبارك وتعالى أن يصلي ويسلم ويبارك عليه وعلى أزواجه الطاهرات أمهاتنا وأمهات المؤمنين وعلى صحابته أجمعين وعلى كل من اقتفى آثارهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وما بعد. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في محكم تنزيله بعد التعوذ في سورة المائدة: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا من يرتد منكم عن دينه فسوف يأتي الله بقوم يحبهم ويحبونه أذلة على المؤمنين أعزة على الكافرين يجاهدون في سبيل الله ولا يخافون لومة لائم ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء والله واسع عليم. We praise Allah and we thank Him always for all of His countless blessings upon us, especially for guiding us to Islam. We recognize that of all Allah's blessings upon us, selecting us to be one of the Muslims is the greatest of all the blessings. And so we ask Allah to make us firmer in our faith, more convinced in our convictions, more steadfast and upright and guided in our deeds, while we testify that there is no deity deserving of being worshipped except Allah alone. He has no equals and He has no partners. And we bear witness that Muhammad, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, is the slave and messenger of Allah, who Allah has sent with guidance and with the religion of truth. We testify that he, with Allah's help and by the permission of Allah, received Allah's message. He understood Allah's message. He accepted Allah's message. And he started with himself and implemented it first and foremost. Then he called to it. And he taught it. And he established it. And he defended it and he supported it with his entire life and all the resources that Allah provided him with. Hence, on behalf of us here today and the rest of the entire ummah, we ask Allah to shower His choicest blessings and send His peace on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and on his wives, our mothers, the mothers of the believers, and his companions who believed in him and stood by his side and supported him, and all those who believed in him and continue to believe in him and follow him in goodness until Yawm al-Qiyamah. Ameen ya Rabb. Allah says in Quran in Surah Al-Ma'idah, chapter 5, verse 54, after seeking protection in Allah from Satan, the accursed, in the name of Allah, the merciful to the entire creation, especially merciful to the believers, Allah says, O believers, if you turn back from your deen, if you apostate from Islam, then Allah will bring a people to replace you. Allah will love them. They will love Him. They will be gentle to the believers and firm against the disbelievers, those who oppose Islam. And they will struggle in the path of Allah and not be afraid of the ridicule or the rebuke of anyone who ridicules or rebukes them. That is the bounty of Allah. He gives it to whomever He chooses. And Allah has tremendous bounties. Wallahu wasi'un alim, He's knowledgeable. He knows who deserves this special bounty of Allah and everything else. This deen of Allah survived intact for more than 14 centuries. And it will be preserved until Yawm al-Qiyamah. The Quran remains with us today unadulterated, untampered with, the way Jibreel alayhi salam brought it down to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that we need to be able to understand Quran and implement its instructions remain intact today, so we can follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The tools necessary to be able to understand and interpret these two sources of Islamic knowledge remain intact, the Arabic language and all components within it. This deen has been preserved. There are still people who understand this deen and love this deen and practice this deen. There are people who call to this deen and they teach this deen. There are people who establish this deen, they defend it, and they support it whenever it needs support. There will always be. But embedded in this ayah and similar verses in Quran, there is a threat. Allah has threatened us. It's a promise also, that if we relinquish our responsibilities, if we abandon the posts of preserving this deen and practicing it and living it and calling to it, He'll find someone else who'll do it. And this is not something that perhaps happened or may happen in the future. This is a dynamic, constant process. We see people who abandon this deen. We see people who are born in Islamic countries with Islamic names in Muslim families, and they turn away from the deen. They left off the Quran. They leave off salah. They're even ashamed to identify as Muslims. We see them leaving the deen the way the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, they will fly from the deen the way the arrows fly from the bows. We also see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens up the hearts of people and they respond to the call of Allah and they accept this deen and they implement it and they study it and they teach it and they call to it. Allah says in the Quran, and He loves them and they love Him and they're gentle to the believers. We ought to learn to be gentle to each other and leave judgments that are none of our business to the judge, Maliki Yawm al-Din, and come together to preserve this deen. This necessity, this need, should make us put aside all of our superficial differences and bond together to support the deen. Allah says the struggle in the path of Allah. Yes, it's a struggle being a Muslim. Studying Islam is not easy. Teaching it is difficult. Living it is very hard. It's like holding on to a brand of coal or fire in your hands. It's not politically correct. It's difficult being a Muslim these days. But yet, they do it. That's part of the jihad. And then, they're not afraid of anyone except Allah. And the truth is, anyone who fears Allah fears no one else. And the one who fears people will never fear Allah. The heart has only place for one, Allah or others. مَا جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لِرَجُلٍ مِّن قَلْبَيْنِ فِي جَوْفِهِ. Allah has not placed two hearts in the cavity of a human being. The word jawf, by the way, combines asadr wal-batn, the chest and the stomach. Once Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sitting with the companions and he read A similar verse in the Quran. I'll read that verse for you. The verse says, it's the last verse of Surah Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, chapter 47, verse 38. Allah says, ha antum ha'ula'i tud'auna litunfiqu fi sabilillah. Faminkum man yabkhul wa man yabkhul fa innama yabkhul 'an nafsihi. Wallahu al-ghani wa antumul fuqara. Wa in tatawallaw yastabdil qauman ghayrakum thumma la yakunu amsalakum. Narju an akuna minhum inshaAllah. Here you are being called to financially support Islam, to spend in the path of Allah. And some of you withhold, you're miserly. And whoever is miserly against himself. He does so only to his own detriment. Why? Allah is al-ghani. Allah has no need. And you are in need of him. Then Allah said, and if you turn away, what it means, if you refuse to financially support Islam, Allah says, we will switch you out with a people other than you. يَسْتَبِدِلْ قَوْمًا غَيْرَكُمْ. He will substitute you for a people other than you. Then they will not be like you. The companions, when they heard this verse, they said, O Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who would we be switched out with? Who would be the substitutes? Amongst those in the gathering was Salman al-Farisi, radiyallahu an. Salman the Persian. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tapped him on his shoulder. And he said, him and his people. Qawman ghayrakum, other than you. Other than people who think they have a birthright to Islam. That we own Islam. Islam is ours. We're the best Muslims. We decide who is Muslims and who is not. That's not how it works. Islam is the deen of Allah. Remember in the ayah? ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah gives it to whomever he pleases, whoever he chooses, not who you decide. In fact, the threat here is that it can be taken from you. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, him and his people, he did not mean only the Persians, but the foreigners. Anyone who accepts this deen when it comes to him. And alhamdulillah, throughout history, people from all parts of this world have responded to the call of Islam and contributed to the longevity of this deen. Yes, just to name a few. The Indians. Are you guys aware of the service of the Indians to Islam, to Islamic knowledge? And our African brothers. Do you all know the scholars amongst the Africans? Some of the greatest scholars and the people in the area of what you call the stands, the former Soviet Union. And Islam spread all over the world. And people respond to the call of Allah. And people love this Quran. And they read this Quran and they memorize this Quran and they protect this Quran. And the rest of the deen. Some of us, we feel like we own Islam. And we're better than those who accept Islam. No, you're not. Read Quran. Read the description of those who accept Islam. Remember, all the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were converts, or if you prefer, reverts. Allah describes them in Quran. Allah says, is the one who was dead. And then Allah brought him back alive. وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ. And we gave him a light with which he walked. كَمَنْ مَثَلُهُ فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ. Like the ones who are in darknesses. Yes, when a person accepts Islam, Allah gives him a light that he walks with. In the Quran, in Surah Al-Hadid, Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا آمنوا بالله ورسوله يؤتكم كفلين من رحمته ويجعل لكم نورا تمشون به ويغفر لكم والله غفور رحيم. This ayah is addressing the Christians. Allah is talking in the context of the followers of Isa alayhi salam. He addressed them as believers because they believed in him. Allah says, all those who believed in Isa alayhi salam, believe in Allah and his messenger. Now respond and believe in Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah will give you double measure of his mercy. And he will give you a light with which you will walk amongst mankind. And he will forgive you for your sins. And Allah is forgiving. And Allah is merciful. What's wrong with us? What's wrong with us that we don't support our deen the way we ought to? Why? Why do we need to do fundraising to pay the bills in this masjid? Why do we have to beg people to support Islamic schools and da'wah? Don't we know that we need money to be able to establish this deen and promote it? Don't we realize that when we said La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that embedded within that was a promise, was a commitment that we will support this deen? Do you know the Christians have something called tithe? You know what tithe is? Literally, linguistically, one-tenth. Skimmed off the top like the cream from milk. That's before taxes. If we were to give 1% as Muslims from our earning, commit to supporting Islam, we will never ever have to ask for money. By the way, I'm not doing fundraising. I'm just reminding you of our responsibility towards our deen. What is wrong with us? Allah asked that question in Quran. Allah says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu ma lakum. What is wrong with you? إِذَا قِيلَ لَكُمْ انْفِرُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ اثَّاقَلْتُمْ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ أَرَضِيتُمْ بِالْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا مِنَ الْآخِرَةِ فَمَا مَتَاعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ إِلَّا تَنْفِرُوا يُعَذِّبَكُمْ عَذَابًا أَلِيمًا. That's number one. وَيَسْتَبْدِلْ قَوْمًا غَيْرَكُمْ وَلَا تَضُرُّوهُ شَيْئًا وَاللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. O believers, what is wrong with you that when it is said, go out in the path of Islam, go out in the path of Allah. What it means here in this ayah is go out in the path of jihad. This surah is talking about in the context of the expedition of Tabuk, defending Islam. What is wrong with you that when it said, go out in the path of Allah, you become heavy on the earth, meaning you drag your feet. You make every kind of excuses. Is it? Allah is proposing a potential here. Is it that you're pleased with the material life in preference of the next life? Is that the reason? Allah is asking, is that the reason? Is it that we love the dunya so much? Is it that we are oblivious of the value of the akhirah? Have we compared this material life to the akhirah and preferred the dunya? Allah answered, فَمَا مَتَاعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ. The pleasures of this life compared to the next life are but little. Are pleasures worth it to disobey Allah? Are pleasures lasting? When we disobey Allah, how long does the pleasure last? And perhaps the sin remains forever. Or when we feel pain in serving the deen, how long does the pain last? Can you still feel the hunger from the last Ramadan? Do you still feel the thirst? Do you still feel the pain in your feet when you stood up for long Taraweeh? No, you don't. The pain, they go away quickly. But the rewards are written in a book that does not forget. The pleasures of this life in front of the next are but little. Allah continues, Allah said, if you do not go out. And this ayah is talking about jihad. But you can extrapolate it to the rest of the responsibilities of supporting this deen. If you do not go out, we will punish you a painful punishment. And we will switch you out with other people. We will substitute you
out and replace you with people other than you. قَوْمًا غَيْرَكُمْ. And you will not harm him, that is Allah, in the least. And Allah is capable of all things. You think he can't do it? He's capable of all things. Not only has he done it, he continues to do it. So I leave you only with one question. Each of us, am I one who has been substituted with, perhaps will be substituted? We ask Allah for his forgiveness, for indeed he's most forgiving, most merciful. أستغفر الله ربي لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وبعد. My dear brothers and sisters, Islam need all of us. Need in the sense that there is scope for each of us to serve. Let's look into this ummah. Let's find something that Allah has given us the capacity to serve in. Huh? Whether it's legal defense, whether it's da'wah, whether it's education, even if it's cutting the grass in the masjid. Let's find something to help this deen and do it. Don't wait to be asked. Don't wait until there's an election and then you're elected and then you feel you can serve the masjid or the deen of Allah. And if you're not elected, then you're not needed. No, we're all needed. And because we're not pulling, some of us are not pulling our weight, all of us collectively suffer. And we run the risk of being switched out. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he help us to recognize what a blessing it is that we have been made members in this mighty, magnificent ummah of people who follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put love for Allah, love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, love for our deen, and love for each other in our hearts. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mobilize us so we get up and do something to serve our deen. Study the deen. Study. This deen is rich with knowledge. Teach what you know, what you have the ability to teach. Call to it. Be a good example, live it. Go out there and be whatever profession you are. Live as a Muslim. Be just. Be compassionate. That's the best da'wah. Justice and compassion. And then identify as a Muslim. That's the best da'wah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he help us. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. And I ask Allah to show his choice, his blessings, and send his peace on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma rabbana salli wa sallim wa barik ala abdika wa rasulika Muhammadin al-Mustafa alladhi jahada fi sabilika haqqa jihadik wa ala azwajihi tahirat ummahatina wa ummahatil mu'minin wa ala al-khulafa al-rashidin Abi Bakr al-Siddiq وعمر بن الخطاب وعثمان بن عفان وعلي بن أبي طالب وعلى سائر أصحاب نبيك أجمعين وعلى كل من اقتفى آثارهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم ربنا أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم ربنا أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم ربنا أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين وانصر عبادك المؤمنين المجاهدين الذين يجاهدون في سبيلك لإعلاء كلمتك.
اللهم ربنا أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم اللهم ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وتقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتوب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم عباد الله إن الله تعالى يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمنا وإياكم الله وأقيموا الصلاة
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
كما اعتدوا سوى صفوفكم صلوا صلاة مؤذن فعسى أن تكون آخر صلاة Straighten your lines, leave no gaps between you or your brothers. Sisters, the requirement to stand next to your sister and leave no spaces between you is as much for the sisters as it is for the brothers. Let's pray as if it's the final prayer, it may very well be. Allah Akbar. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين يا أيها الذين آمنوا من يرتد منكم عن دينه فسوف يأتي الله بقوم يحبهم ويحبونه أذلة على المؤمنين أذلة على المؤمنين عزة على الكافرين يجاهدون في سبيل الله ولا يخافون لومة لائم ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء والله واسع عليم الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim. Maliki Yawmiddin. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا ما لكم إذا قيل لكم انفروا في سبيل الله اثاقلتم ما لكم إذا قيل لكم انفروا في سبيل الله اثاقلتم إلى الأرض أرضيتم بالحياة الدنيا من الآخرة فما متاع الحياة الدنيا في الآخرة إلا قليل إلا تنفروا يعذبكم عذابا أليما ويستبدل قوما غيركم ولا تضروه شيئا والله على كل شيء قدير. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. If you don't mind waiting for a minute, my brother Khalil, me addresses you.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. Assalamu alaikum, everyone. My name is Khalil Meek. I'm visiting you from Dallas.